Hi, let's talk about the arteries of the superior mediastinum and root of the neck. The story of any artery really begins with that of the aorta, and the aorta begins as a vessel that leaves the left ventricle and becomes the ascending aorta. That ascending aorta transitions into the arch of the aorta, or aortic arch. And that arch has three major branches from it. There's the brachiocephalic trunk, the left common carotid artery, and the left subclavian artery. The arch of the aorta then transitions into the descending aorta, which has both thoracic and abdominal parts. The other major artery leaving the heart comes from the right ventricle, and that's the pulmonary trunk. The pulmonary trunk is going to divide into left and right pulmonary arteries. And we can see a remnant of a novelty of fetal circulation called the ligamentum arteriosum at the origin of the right pulmonary artery. Now, ligamentum arteriosum would conduct relatively rich oxygenated blood coming from the placenta, having traveled through fetal circulation through the pulmonary trunk to the arch of the aorta. So, in effect, it's a bypass of pulmonary circulation for that blood. As we take a closer look at the branches coming from the arch of the aorta. And you'll have to excuse this image because there's still pericardium on these great vessels, but we can see the brachiocephalic trunk, the left common carotid artery, and the left subclavian artery. That brachiocephalic trunk is going to branch into the right subclavian artery and the right common carotid artery. The subclavian arteries are going to serve predominantly the upper limbs, but they'll also serve the head and neck, as well as the walls of the thorax and abdomen. Whereas the common carotid arteries are going to bifurcate into the internal and external carotid arteries. The internal carotid artery predominantly supplies the cranial cavity with blood, the brain with blood, and it does send a branch out through the orbit, the ophthalmic artery, which supplies the orbit, the eye, various related features, and the superficial brow, whereas the external carotid artery serves the neck, face, and head with blood. Let's take a look at a subclavian artery in the root of the neck. The subclavian artery, if you recall, has three parts that are defined by their relationship to the anterior scalene muscle. The first part of the subclavian artery is everything medial to the edge of the anterior scalene muscle. The second part is anything behind that anterior scalene muscle. And the third part is anything lateral to the anterior scalene muscle out to the lateral margin of the first rib, where it then becomes the axillary artery. Now, that first part of the subclavian artery has three branches, one of which is germane to today's, or this session's lab, and that is the internal thoracic artery. That internal thoracic artery is going to descend the thorax, sending out branches of the pericardiacophrenic artery, anterior intercostal branches 1 through 6, and then its terminal branches will be the musculophrenic artery and the superior epigastric artery. Thank you very much for your time.